Welcome to my secret place devotion with Oyiks, Alfred. The Word of God is alive and equipped to change your life.
Morning. There's no need to worry about the rest of the year because in Philippians 1:6, the Bible tells us that we should be confident about this very thing, that the one who has already started a good work in us will complete it, will not abandon it, will finish it up until the end. He will keep on working in our lives in the name of Jesus. So, Father, thank you so much for this encouraging word. And, Lord, we open up ourselves to you that you keep on working in our lives, oh Lord, until we become exactly like you. In Jesus' name, amen. If you've been following our devotional for this month of February, we've been looking at the indices of a disciple. And we've been looking a lot at Luke chapter 9 verse 23, where Jesus by himself identified the indices of discipleship. We've looked at the first indice of discipleship, which is having a strong desire to be a disciple. Because that verse in Luke chapter 9 verse 23 starts by saying, if any man desires to be a disciple, or if any man wants to be a disciple. So first you have to decide you want to be a disciple. Then the second thing Jesus said is he must deny himself. And that is the second condition for discipleship. But today we want to take a look at how self expresses himself. Now, what does that mean? Remember, Jesus said, you must deny yourself if you are going to be his disciple, which means you must deal with self. We've looked at it a lot at the devotional, talking a lot about self. But let us look at how self expresses itself so that when self is in operation, you know that it is self. Remember, we've said that self is the biggest enemy to a committed life to Jesus Christ. Self will fight you. We've said that self is, number one, an opinion that is contrary to Christ. So how it expresses itself is that it keeps on giving its own plans, its own ideas, its own ways that are very different from God's own ways. That is the first way that self expresses itself. But then the other expressions, number two, is called personal projection or self-exaltation. What does that mean? It means pushing yourself forward and above others. So you always want to be seen, you always want to be noticed. And you know, to exalt yourself is to put yourself in an improper place. You know, when people always want to be noticed, when they want everybody to know they are the one behind this, they are the one giving this, they are the one that did the project, they never want to just keep quiet, they just want to voice out and make very loud, I'm the one behind this. When they give people money or when they help someone, they just can't keep quiet. They must receive the glory. So the Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 6 verse 2, it says, so when you give to the needy, do not announce it with trumpets as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and on the street to be honored by others. I tell you the truth, they have already received their reward in full. So how does self express itself? Self makes sure that it heightens itself above others. Self expresses itself by being noticed. You know, yourself rises up instead of Christ. When you see self, self always gives glory to self. Self wants to attract glory and attention to himself. So one of the ways that self expresses itself is through self-exaltation. They always exalt themselves. You know, if they are somewhere and someone says, oh, this project is very good, they just can't bear it to just keep quiet and let that comment slide. They must say, oh, you know what, I'm the one involved in this. If someone says, oh, whoever helped him did such an excellent job by helping give this poor man clothes, they can't keep quiet. They must say, oh yeah, I was one that gave the money. You know, if you can't do something with and just keep quiet about it, recognize that self is in operation. Self will rather give glory to itself than to give glory to God, which is why Jesus fights self. He said the first thing you have to do is to deny yourself if you're going to be a disciple. Now, remember that a man who is truly a disciple is going to work signs and wonders, going to work miracles. His character would be seen. And the tendency for people to praise that individual is very high. So that person has a tendency to also absorb the glory and take the glory rather than deflecting the glory back to Christ. And you can't have two masters in one boat, which is why Jesus said you have to deny self so that I get my glory. Jesus will not share his glory with a man who is still struggling with self. So when a man has failed to deny himself, you see him projecting self, you see him exalting self, he must be praised, he must be recognized, He must be noticed. Everybody must know he's one behind this project. Everybody must know he's one behind this giving. They never do anything anonymous. And they usually will take the glory for themselves rather than giving it to Christ. And that is why Jesus said, when you have made up your mind to be a disciple, then the next thing you must do, you must deny self so that Jesus will have his full glory. Another way that self expresses itself is, you know, getting attention and focus on himself. And anything that person does is about himself, never about others. So you see people who are extremely selfish, they think about themselves in every conversation, they think about themselves in every single thing they are doing. They can never do anything just so that the kingdom of God will be promoted. They are not going to get anything from the advancing the kingdom of God. They are not going to do it. And therefore Jesus said, you must deal with self. A perfect verse of scripture that describes the selfless life is in Philippians chapter 2, verse 3 to 6. It says, do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourself. Not looking to your own interests, but each of you, the interests of others. In your relationship with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus, who being in the very nature of God, did not consider equality with God as something to be used to his own advantage. So you see, Jesus Christ, though he was God, the Bible says he wasn't selfish about it. He didn't consider it something to be used for his own advantage. He kept on thinking of how he was going to advance the kingdom of God, how he was going to do what God asked him to do. And that scripture we read in verse 4, it said, stop looking out for your interests only. Look out for the interests of others. Everything's not about you. The world does not revolve around you. It revolves around Jesus Christ. So self focuses attention on himself. He's always thinking about himself and all that. With that kind of attitude, it will be difficult for that man to follow Jesus. Even if that man is a Christian, he's in church, everything he or she is doing is about self. If he's preaching, that self is supposed to bring glory to him and not to the Lord, and obviously never to others. And so that is something that Jesus wants us to deal with if we're going to be on this journey of discipleship with him. The Bible says, if you do not deny yourself, you cannot be my disciple. And cannot is a very strong term. It means you can be any other thing, but you can never be my disciple unless you deal with self. So tomorrow we're going to look at, how do we deny self? How do you deal with self? How do you bring down self? How do you address this? Because if you do not address self, all you are is a child of God. You will not progress into a deeper walk with God. You'll be superficial with the Lord, and the Lord will also be superficial with you. Remember from the scripture in Matthew 13:10, the Bible said, the disciples came to him and asked him, why do you speak to the people in parables? Then Jesus replied, because the knowledge of the secrets of the kingdom of heaven has been given to you, my disciples, but not to them. So the secrets of God is usually released to disciples. It will never be released to just random or regular people who just come to church and go back without taking the journey of discipleship. So if you want to go deeper with God, the next phase in your journey is discipleship. And you can't do that until you learn how to deal with self, which we're going to take a look at tomorrow. Stay tuned. Don't miss tomorrow's edition. It will change your life forever.
For other life-changing messages, you can now download the app Rev Oyiks Speaks from Play Store for Android phone users or Apple Store for iOS users. You can also follow us on Instagram, YouTube, and Telegram, all on the handle Oyiks Alfred.